You are looking live, everybody, at what could be the most anticipated comedy show in all of history. What's up, everybody? I'm Matthew Ford. Welcome to the seventh level of GT's Bedroom Comedy Showcase, coming to you tonight from the intersection of Peace and Love Streets. Just a reminder, we want the show to be the talk of the town. So everybody, please comment down below, whatever you want. Give a voice, all right? Don't be afraid to speak up. We enjoy hearing your thoughts and prayers during the show. And as always, we'll give shout-outs to the funniest mentions. But first, let's briefly check in with a lady who's always got her finger on the pulse here at our bedroom showcase, Miss Ashley Preston. Ashley, what's going on?
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, I'm just here with my friend.
It looks like that's a grower right there.
Definitely a grower, not a shower. My friend, we've been having some good conversations here lately about the, as Lucy Moore says, quarantine. So we're just here tonight. We're going to have a good time and going to sprinkle a little water, a little fertilizer.
That's all. I hope that tree's like 10 feet tall but next time we come to you.
Okay, we'll see.
All right, well, we're going to let a few more people join us here before we officially start the show. But first off, you guys want to know a secret?
Yeah.
Check this out. You know, I'm not actually where you think I am.
What?
Look at this. I'm not actually even in GT's bedroom, folks. This is my office. Look, my girlfriend's on the floor. It's craziness. And look, you aren't even who you think you are. Look at this. You're a camera. You're a fucking camera, all right?
What?
It's a lie. All of TV is a lie. All right. Well, I'm glad I got that out of the way. But first, let's check it. Now that we got that out of the way, let's check in with all of our comics real fast. They are all real, by the way. No smoke and mirrors there, okay? Maybe some smoke. You know who I'm talking about. But they are all here. They are ready to make you guys laugh. And it's going to be a great show. So anyway, tell you what. Why don't we go ahead and start this little show, because we have, like I said, seven very talented comics coming your way. We got a great show for you tonight. Several blatant copyright infringements are here. That's accurate? That's accurate. So please, comics, go ahead and mute your mics real fast for me. We're going to kick things off here as soon as I press this little button. Everybody grab a drink, kick back, relax, feel like a kid again, because GT's Bedroom Comedy Showcase 7 starts right now.
From GT's Bedroom in Clayton, North Carolina, it's GT's Bedroom Comedy Showcase. Tonight, comedians Lucy Moore, Leslie Kirk and Rob Morales, Will Purpura, Bobo Delicious, Jeremy Alder, and Matt White. With Gerald Thomas and the Stuffed Animal All-Stars. Now, here's your host, Matthew Ford.
Did you guys see that, though? The legendary Jay Leno. How about that?
How about Conan O'Brien?
Y'all doing good tonight? Everybody having fun watching our little show here? I can say, honestly, I'm glad to be back with you guys. This show's very cathartic for me, so I enjoy being with you. And now, without further ado, let's get to my hot takes on this week's Hot Topics. In the absence of live crowds, the English Premier League has announced plans to use fake crowd noise from the FIFA video game during their matches. Hey, why just limit it to soccer, I say, right? Goal! G-O-A! You get it. Can you imagine, though? I gotta say, I for one think using fake crowd noise of any kind is just the lowest of low. It's just so disingenuous, you know? Anyway, I'm glad we all agree. Hey now, In a sign of the times, HBO Max's new Looney Tune cartoon series will no longer feature Elmer Fudd, Yosemite Sam, or any other character carrying a gun. Yeah. Although Bugs Bunny dressing up as a girl and seducing Elmer Fudd is still fucking hilarious, right? All right? Look at that. And finally, tonight, hot off the success of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket launch, CEO Elon Musk sent an email to his workers explaining that the company's Starship rocket is the new top priority. Hey, what's the rush? Asked an interested employee. No reason, he said. Let's just hurry up, okay? All right, I gotta get out of here. We can't get enough of our first comic of the evening, making her second appearance on GT's Bedroom Comedy Showcase. Please give it up for the constant gardener, Miss Lucy Moore.
Oh, thank you. Thanks, Matthew. That's really nice. You guys, I was thinking about this morning. Have you ever forgotten a swear word that you really like using, so you try to add it back into your vocabulary? Like the other day, I realized that I haven't been saying the word bastard enough. So I'm going to start using it as much as I can. Like someone opens the door for me, I'm like, it's a compliment because it's a good word. I like it. I'm really sad lately. My depression is in heat. And I icebreaker and conversations. But now everyone has it, so it just makes me sound basic. So now I feel like I'm trying to like compete to make my depression seem worse, you know? Like, have you ever called a hotline? So if you haven't, then you're a therapist. I haven't talked to my therapist in a while, and it makes me feel like she doesn't care, you know? Like, why hasn't she checked up on me? So now I feel like we're both kind of playing hard to get, you know? Having a therapist is a lot like being in a relationship. You have to threaten to kill yourself to get any real attention. Ice cream for breakfast the other day because a boy made me sad 3 years ago. And it made me realize that I reward myself for doing the bare minimum. You know, like the other day I went on an Amazon shopping spree. I was like, I deserve this. I watched a documentary last night. Practically read a book. It was The Bachelor. But, I mean, it's basically a kind of the same thing. Unfortunately, the man I love broke my heart this week, but, you know what he also did, I had to go through a whole roll of 2-ply, so he also killed lots of trees, that bastard. God, it's a good word. I'm late everywhere I go. I'll be going, like, you know, to work. Hey, I'm sorry I'm late. Meeting up with friends. I'm so sorry I'm late. The other day, I'm sorry I'm late. She's like, man, this is a grocery store. Just scan the pregnancy test. Okay, just scan it. Turns out I'm not pregnant. Don't worry. But someone thought I was pregnant the other day because I told them I was pregnant. I just wanted to know what it would be like, you know. It didn't go well. I don't think I'll be getting a third date with him. And honestly, that's where I'm going to leave it for you bastards. And I love you all, and goodbye.
All right. Thank you so much, Lucy. God, I love her.
Daddy, Daddy.
Hey, what's up, GT?
What are these?
Those are rabbit ears.
I think they're not like rabbit feet.
They are better luck than rabbit's feet, actually.
Good question. What do they do?
Well, what do they do? What don't they do? I mean, all right, tell you what, guys. I have an idea, actually. Everybody get your permission slips ready, because GT's Bedroom Comedy Showcase is going on its first ever field trip!
Let's go!
Let's go! Man, we're really breaking the budget on this show.
They could have used special effects, Daddy.
Wow. So that's why they say good artists borrow, but great artists steal. Hey, speaking of, look, we're at the Super Secret TV Museum.
It looks like the Louvre, Daddy.
Wee wee. Wow, look at all these old TVs, GT.
I feel like I'm at Momo and Pawpaw's house. They're here.
Gerald Thomas, what was that?
Daddy, get me out of here.
We're here 5 seconds and you're already ripping off Poltergeist? All right, well, while I try to figure out what channel my son is on, try not to get knocked out by your next comics. Please welcome the always impregnable defense of Mike Tyson comedy, Miss Leslie Kirk and Robert Morales.
That senior photo of Will Purpura on Instagram.
Oh my god, I did. He's such a babyface delight.
Right?
Yeah. He's kind of making me question my sexuality.
Girl, me too.
Ugh. Did you see Bobo's post last week?
Wait, which one?
She was like making egg rolls or something and she was twerking.
Oh yeah, did she ask us for that, right?
Yeah, I think so.
You should sign up.
I'm thinking about it. Yesterday, I was at Weaver Street Market.
Oh yeah?
And I think I saw Jeremy Alder.
Jeremy Alder, wait, did he have his kids with him?
No, he had Hank.
He's the Hillsborough comedian, right?
Yeah.
Wait, not the only one, though. So, what have you been up to today?
Well, at 8 a.m., I got started on heroin.
Oh.
By 10 a.m., I was an addict. At 12 p.m., I sought help. Recovering addict.
Oh, good for you.
And you were here for all of that.
What?
Dropped my needles this morning. You held my hair when I was going through withdrawal.
Oh, it's for the vomiting and stuff.
Yeah.
I totally forgot about that.
What do you do all day? Stop.
Oh, that was good. I got us a CD to listen to.
Yeah. It's anything like what you normally listen to. I'm not. No.
It's now that's what I call music 7.
No.
It's got Destiny's Child.
No, I'm done.
Survivor?
Seriously. No, I'm done.
That's how we got you off heroin.
No, seriously. You're being an asshole. Like.
I'm a survivor.
Stop.
I'm not going to give up.
Quit it. Seriously.
I'm a survivor.
No, seriously. Stop.
Keep on surviving. I've learned a song for you.
About what?
About your struggle with heroin.
Is it like mostly about me?
I mean, pretty much.
If it's all about me, you can play it. But
oh, okay.
Yeah.
Woo!
Everybody hurts. Everybody cries. Is that the kids?
You said you put them to sleep. No, seriously.
I thought it was your night to put them to sleep.
You know I'm just the babysitter. Stop it.
Come on.
You're no, stop. Seriously.
Whatever.
Same shit, different day. Seriously. All right, fuck you.
Whatever.
You're such a piece of shit. I'm done.
God damn it. Hey, can you help me with that project that I was telling you about?
I guess.
right?
What?
You know, seriously.
I'm trying to learn.
No, we're friends. I think we're related. Seriously, stop. Can I teach you something?
What?
Oh my God.
You know what to do? Open her up.
Oh,
dude, come on, man. What? How did you really do that?
Oh, all right. Hey. Thank you so much, Mike Tyson Comedy. Hey, bad news. I just saw y'all's faces on a wanted poster, but the good news is it was issued by my heart. So, all right, let's check back in with our eyes in the skies, Miss Ashley Preston. Ashley, what's going on?
Listen, so this fertilizer that I'm using, it's just this. I won't,
Ooh.
Yeah. I used a little bit of this and my plant grew. And then I used some water. And just like that, my plant grew. Can you believe it?
I cannot.
My friend is having a growth spurt. Also, this, did you know it's gluten-free?
It's healthy?
It's healthy. There's no gluten.
No gluten?
In this.
I love gluten.
I love gluten, but if I didn't love gluten, there's none. In this. Oops.
Well, that's...
So, that's what's happening in my neck of the woods. What's going on over there?
Not much. I think we're just going to keep this little show moving along. Thanks so much, Ashley.
Great. Great.
Hang on, GT. I'm going to get you out of there. Wait. What are you doing? And I Love Lucy. Oh, this is one of the best episodes, too. Hey, take it easy on the candy, oinker. You're going to get an upset stomach, and you got bed in 1 hour. Let's see what else they got here. The Beatles on Sullivan? I would give anything to be there. Oh, that would be me, actually, if I was there. Oh, I can't even imagine. I feel like a screaming little girl right now as well. What else we got? The White House. Oh, what are you doing there? You don't just stroll into the White House. Oh.
Good evening.
Yeah, you might want to sit down for this one.
This is the 37th time I have spoken to you from this office.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see what else. Girlfriend. Oh, Cheers! This is one of my favorite shows from the 80s. Yeah, Cheers! You never heard of Cheers? Well, first of all, you're probably not allowed in a bar. But it's got George Wendt, Woody Harrelson, Ted Danson, Kelsey Grammer. I'm telling you, it's a great show. You should watch it. Whatever. Let's see what else I got. Oh, snap. No, GT. That's not a race, okay? That's a chase. I'll explain it to you when you're older. All right, listen, it's obvious I've got to upgrade my TV package real fast, but while I do that, please welcome your next comic who's never afraid to go full analog, Mr. Will Purpura.
Hey-o, what's going
on? Hey!
I'll say it before, and I'll say it again. Thanks for having me on the show. I'm trying to tweet more, but, I mean, it's hard to get popular on Twitter, right? I mean, it seems like the only way to get trended on Twitter is, like, if you die or if you're part of an underground child trafficking sex cult. And I gotta be honest, I'm not that committed! This is a tough world we're living in, gang, and I'm glad my father isn't alive to see this. Not that I think he can't handle it, I'm just glad he's dead. I like to make stuff up about my dad because he can't fight back. And it's so much more entertaining than the truth, right? like, the truth is, my dad was like, he was a charismatic narcissist who made me into a people pleaser. Boring, right? You want to hear that, or do you want to hear about the time I walked in on him trying to suck his own dick? I say it happened. If it didn't, let him debate me. Oops, I forgot. Can't debate me on it. Social media is toxic. It gives me FOMO.
FOMO?
F-O-M-O. FOMO. Fear of missing out. What do you think I said?
Homo.
FOMO, fear of missing out. Like the other day, this guy posted a picture of his couch. Hey, come on, man. Some of us are still using two chairs and a dog. Oh. I'm looking for a job right now. And I got, you know, these employers are too damn picky, right? They want 2 to 3 years of experience in the same field. All right, NASA sticks to their own kind. I get it. But I'm a fucking catch, okay? Any company would be lucky to have me. I can read, I can write, I recognize most shapes. And that puts me ahead of Dan Quayle. Uh-oh. That means it's time for tonight's retro joke of the week. The joke was, I can recognize most shapes, puts me ahead of Dan Quayle. Dan Quayle was the vice president from 1989 to 1993. Retro joke of the week. All right. Time for a meme. Mm. You can do memes in stand-up. Yeah, you can. My plans, staying in Reed, 2020. Okay. I don't miss people. I got to be honest. I am adapting. I don't miss people, but I miss telling people I'm busy. I'm running out of excuses. Oh, I can't make your Zoom wedding. I forgot. I'm dead. I don't want to go back to interning, but I'll do it. I was always the intern in the office who wanted to get in good with the whole group, you know, like, here's your coffee, sweet and low for Katie. Katie loves sweet and low, right? We are a bunch of crazy, kooky coworkers, aren't we? All of us, me included. They should do a show about us, right? A sitcom. Because it's funny in here. Who'd play Katie? Who'd play her? Come on. If something opens up, I'm available. Everybody's talking about Marriage Story, and I'm not excluded. Everybody's hot for Marriage Story. I had a problem with it because the characters were just too intelligent to relate to. You know, it was like, you never congratulated me for the genius grant. I've never been in a relationship like that. I wish they would make it more white trash. You never congratulated me on beating up that carny who cheated me in whack-a-mole. I needed your support on that. What? How am I doing on time?
Oh, you got 7 more seconds.
Okay. I love talking after sex, but I talk after sex the way you talk after a movie. I go, so, what was your favorite part? All right. Thanks, everybody. That was fun.
Oh, my God. Thanks, as always, Willie P. Real Purpura.
All right. I've upgraded. Let's see if this thing works.
Didn't get any bread. Just forget it. Let it go.
Seinfeld's on. I love this show. Hey, wait a minute. There's a button that says enter. You forgot my bread. I wonder if that'll let me enter the TV. Let's try it. Everyone in front of me got free. Whoa, it actually works. Beam me up, Scotty. Hey, Gerald Thomas, once you're done, I got an idea. No soup for you. These guys are pricks. Let's try another channel. Hey, Mr. Hanky!
The Christmas Poo!
How do you know about this show?
Well, I've always watched it, but it's starting to go down the toilet.
Yeah, kinda right. Alright, well, let's try again. Oh, GT, look, it's one of my favorite shows!
The Golden Girls?
Close. Lost, actually. Oh man, I feel like I've died and gone to heaven.
Yeah, just like the show ended, right, Daddy?
Right. Yeah, let's try again.
Yeah.
GT, get down!
What's this show about, Daddy?
Hugs. It's about warm hugs.
You sure it's not about drugs?
Yeah, let's...
Oh, what a controversial ending this was.
That's it?
What?
I kind of smacked.
Yeah.
All right. Well, while I check out our streaming options, I hope none of you stop believing in this crazy journey called life. In the meantime, though, everybody put your chopsticks together for the incomparable...
Bobo!
Delicious!
Hey! What's up, y'all? What's up? What's up? Welcome back to... I know lots of people is like, what is Bobo's going to do this time? And I know I'm taking a break from Bobo Quarantine Kitchen and also from the sensational massage lesson last time. I'm actually doing comedy on the couch.
Oh.
I know it's not, yes. So, I mean, it's not like a therapist session or anything because I'm not certified. But if you want me to listen to your shitty problem and pay me, I am more than happy to take your money. Venmo me, baby. Okay, so one thing that I have to, you know, what a coincidence, because apparently I found out that one of my neighbor, actually, her ex-husband left her for a massage therapist. And at first, I thought maybe she gave like amazing, like happy ending or something, but turned out it was not the case. It's because the woman doesn't talk. The only thing she asked, the only two things she says, are you comfortable and is it going to be cash or car? So, but anyway, I hope everyone doing great. Everyone is, you know, I know it's such, there's so much tension in the air. And so I just want to, you know, provide a little bit comic relief. I just want to talk about everything that happened that I noticed in the last 2 weeks, okay? First of all, I know everyone is staying at home, eating a bunch of shit, gaining a bunch of weight. I myself gaining the COVID-19 pound, okay? How come Khloe Kardashian get out of the pandemic looking like a whole new person?
Money.
Like, money. I'm telling you, listen. If Khloe Kardashian submit to go to a Khloe Kardashian look-alike contest, I think she's not going to even make it to the first round. And that's what I'm saying, that the Kardashian get upgrade like iPhones. I want to know, how can I get that? My little cousin is making them in a factory. How can I get that? The Kardashian upgrade too. But anyway, another thing, you know, I don't know about y'all, but like, I felt a little like social deprived. Like I just felt like a lot of people is like getting married and having, you know, getting engaged, having a lot of like big celebration in life, you know, buy a new house, have babies. And I felt like, you know, it just with the whole pandemic going on, we like missing out on so much like, you know, big celebrations and stuff. But one thing I don't miss though, I don't miss touring people's houses. Like, that's weird, okay? Where I came from, we don't tour people's houses. If we want something, we just steal it, okay? Here, you come to people, like, the people buy new houses,
and they invite you to a housewarming, okay? And then you came, and then you have like tiptoeing around and look at all the bathroom and see if they have an extra Adderall or something. Oh, you know? So I was like, that is kind of strange. And like, what am I gonna find in your closet? And then people always make sure that they clean the house up really nice before you let them tour the house. I was like, this, your house have two bedrooms, two baths, the same cookie cutter kitchen, it's nothing different. Now, if you got a sex dungeon, like, sign me up. I want to see that shit. Okay. but one thing I don't miss, okay? One thing I don't miss. Have you ever shown up at people's house and it's like, they have this, like, decoration that straight out, that looked just like Chips and JoJo games, and it's like a big old freaking sign say farmhouse. Bitch, you live in a condo. If your house is a farmhouse, if I show up at your house, I better see some animal fucking. Okay? If you ain't got no goat, if you ain't got no chicken, if you ain't got no horses running around, that is not a farmhouse. Okay, if you and your husband dressing up as animal and fucking each other, that does not qualify your house as a farmhouse. That's a condo. Okay. And another thing I want to tell you, so you heard the term, don't trust a skinny cook, right? Right? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I don't trust people with houses that look like they came out of Pinterest. And also, anyone that have a pillow, a blanket, a sign that say, bless this mess. Your house is perfect. What the fuck are you talking about? What kind of mess are you talking about? You're talking about your marriage? just me. Let's see, what else? You know what's something I'm really excited about? The salon opened back up a couple weeks ago. So bitch, we're excited, you know. But no, like, I'm like, people like, oh, you're gonna go get waxes and stuff. I was like, no. Like, I'm not all for the waxing because my eyebrow has been social distancing since 2005, okay? this shit didn't survive the early 2000s, okay? So there's no need. But I got my toes done. And while I was getting my toes done, I was sitting next to a girl who's getting ready to get on a Zoom date, which is super cute. And she was like, oh my gosh, I have a Zoom date tonight. So I'm gonna get these super pink colors on my toes. I was like, you're getting your toes done for a Zoom date? I was like, this, if you shown your toes on your Zoom date, you better charge money. Mm-hmm. You know? I'm like, girl, I think you should charge. You just go ahead and put your Venmo in the chat so they can sell Venmo you. But anyway, so I'll think about it. I know everyone. Hold on. Y'all hear that?
Hmm?
Hold on one minute. I think I got a phone call. Hello? Oh, hi. Welcome to customer service. Bitch, I'm so sorry. I can't help you. Everyone dying of the coronavirus right now. Okay, bye. Sorry. That was worth calling. One thing that I want to tell them, so I had an idea, right? Like, what can I do as a side hustle, right? So I thought about it and I was like, you know, at first I was like, oh my god, it would be terrible if I get coronavirus, but what happened if I get the antibody? Like, mm-hmm. I could be like a date surrogate. Okay, if you meet Giselle online and Giselle don't want to come see you, Giselle can just give me a picture of her face. I post it on my face. I'll show up. Giselle with a side of soy sauce. Okay? But call me on my cell phone. Just a little something. Doing what you do. If anyone out there, if you feel like, you know, it's a terrible times right now with everything going on. Stay positive. Stay safe. Take care of yourself. Take care of your loved ones.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Bobo. I can't help but notice that adorable plant that's right behind you. Let's go now to our other horticulturist? It's a word. Ashley Preston.
So it was like, it was about this size, but it was a little bit shorter. And I was
Ashley,
just like,
Ashley, you know you're on, right?
Hey.
Yeah, you're on. Sorry about that.
My bad. I was talking to my friend. This is actually Bobo's plant's cousin.
Oh.
They're cousins, yeah. They grew up together. We were just talking about other horticulture and the English cucumber. So, that's all. Nothing awkward. Nothing to see here, folks.
All right. Thank you so much, Ashley. We'll check back with you in a minute.
Okay, GT, we're almost home.
Hey, it's Lonely Island.
Hey, that's right. This is what started it all, the digital age of TV.
Hey, I have an idea. Let's hit it.
See what else is on. Oh, no. I used to watch Full House as a kid, but this show is garbage.
Then why'd you put it in the show then, Daddy?
Clickbait. I'll tell you this one. I was a great wife. How's it? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it was my turn. Miss Maisel, seriously, you're one of the reasons I got into stand-up comedy. If you guys haven't seen this show, it is hilarious. It's on Amazon Prime. You'll be laughing from here to 1920.
Stranger Things!
Oh, I love this show. Hold on, this is kind of a scary part. You may want to close your eyes. Run, Winona!
Yeah! Baby Yoda, he's so cute!
Oh, he sure is.
Daddy, can we please keep talking?
No, I think George Lucas owns the rights to him.
Oh!
Alright, let's see what else.
Is that LeBron James?
That's Michael Jordan.
Is that his dad?
Something like that. All right, well, this may be our last dance as well, but first, please welcome your next comic who has spent more money than MJ probably on helping total strangers during this pandemic. An all-around great guy and hilarious comic making his GT's BCS debut. Please welcome Mr. Jeremy Alder. The franchise is going to change.
Hey! good to see everybody. Glad to be here. I haven't done comedy in 3 months, so that's all my jokes.
Hey! Well, thank you so much.
Hey! I assume everybody's done with their standing ovation, and I'll just jump right in. Corona, not a fan. not a fan. Hasn't been great. I've been stuck at home for the last who knows how long with my kids, and it's really made me think a lot about myself and kind of reevaluating a lot of things. I'm learning a lot of things about myself being quarantined, especially as a father. I've realized that I don't want kids. Shut up, you guys. I'm on a comedy show. I don't know. It's crazy, man. It's been quite a ride. I've been doing not a lot. I've been basically my day is dishes and walking. And I feel like I'm probably better than I've ever. I take a lot of walks, so I'm probably better than I've ever been at walking, like in my life. Like, I think I'm probably better than I ever will be right now. I'm peak walking right now. And I don't know what to do with that. I feel like it's underappreciated. And I don't know how to monetize it. So if anybody has any ideas, I'm an elite level walker right now. Also, I've got my 10,000 hours in doing dishes. So I think I am an expert on dishes. So if anybody has any questions about how to do that, I'm happy to help out with that in any way I can. I don't know, this Corona stuff, it's weird. I think it's a really terrible time to be an old person. I think it was really interesting how, as soon as people realized that Corona mainly affects old people, it was like, fuck them. Let's go. Let's do this. Like, fuck old people. Like, I don't know. Like, I feel like, you know, like if you're in a nursing home right now, goddamn, that's like the worst place. I realize like the people that like are like most pushing to like go outside right now and not wear a mask are pro-life people, and which helped me realize that actually nursing homes are abortion clinics for pro-life boomers who aren't ready to have parents. They're like, you know what? My parents, my choice, and I choose golf. I don't know. It is weird. I've been getting harassed. Well, I don't know. It might be a little strong, but definitely like called out by people like in public and on Twitter and stuff for wearing a face mask when I go out. And people have accused me of virtue signaling because I'm wearing a face mask. And which is weird to me because like the reason you wear a face mask is so you don't get other people's sick, right? And if wearing a face mask is virtue signaling, then choosing not to wear a face mask, what is that signaling? I think it's signaling being an asshole. I think it's asshole signaling. If you're not wearing a mask right now, when you go out in public, you're asshole signaling. You're basically just letting people know, I am a selfish asshole. I am a dick. I don't care if your grandma dies. I don't care if anybody gets sick. It's too hard for me to put on a fucking mask. Like, I don't get it. Honestly, like it drives me up a wall. It's the easiest thing in the world to put on a mask. They look cool. When you sneeze in a mask, you get a little taste of yourself, which doesn't always happen. That's not an everyday occurrence. So, you know, it's kind of special. And I think we should take advantage of it and enjoy it and get to know ourselves a little bit from the inside out. What else? What are we doing here? New shit. Oh, yeah. You know, it's crazy watching all these white people with their guns, like, you know, ready to take on the government so they could go out and, you know, get a haircut or, you know, do whatever. Like, I don't know. Here's one thing I've realized. Like, if there's anything, then going to work every day, it's staying at home with their families. Like, that's clear. Like, people are like, as soon as they were like 2 weeks into this thing, they were like, fuck it. Grab the guns, honey. We're going to see the governor, and we are demanding that we get to go back to work. Like, even Elon Musk was like, I'm going to risk going to jail and open up my factory. I'd rather do that than spend one more day at home with my goth wife and my robot baby. Like, I'm not doing it anymore. Like, I'm not, can't do it. It's crazy. I don't know. I think, although, like, what we've realized in the last couple of weeks is that it's still the case that the most effective way to get white people to finally stay the fuck home is civil rights movement. Start protesting in the streets, people will stay the fuck home. That's the only thing that works still. Like, nothing's changed. Wild, man. I don't know. What else? What else is going on? How are we doing on time here? I don't want to blow the light like Bobo did.
Yeah, I know. She's never being asked back, by the way.
All right. What else? Oh, man, people are going crazy in quarantine. My girlfriend pulled her own IUD out with her hands.
What? How?
No.
How?
How?
Like, like she... You want me to
It wasn't in good. It couldn't have been in good.
Just like this.
Wow.
Just like that, yeah.
Wow.
So I don't know. I mean, I'm in awe of that. I realize that I am no longer the alpha in this relationship, if I ever was. She's an absolute beast. It's incredible. Thankfully, I got fixed a while back. So we'll be good. I did have one kid after I got fixed. So you know, the doctor didn't do a great job, but we can't demand perfection out of our medical professionals, especially right now. You know what I'm saying? They're under a lot of stress. And you know, it's an inexact science, clearly, vasectomies. And that's actually what I named my kid, was inexact science. That's my youngest son. And he's actually listening right now and learning a whole lot about himself and his dad. So how are we doing on time? I honestly don't know how I'm doing.
Oh, you're
on
time. Any time. You...
Okay. All right. I don't know that I had much else prepared. This has been a lot of fun though.
Yeah.
Thank you, Matt, for having me.
Oh, thank you, Jeremy. Everybody, make sure you follow this guy on Facebook and Instagram. He is a genius when it comes to observational humor and witty political commentary. So
finally, somebody recognizing.
Thank you. I'm here.
Did you hear that, Mom? Mom, are you watching? Listen to this man. Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Good to see everybody. Bye.
Oh my God, GT, we escaped the TV museum, or the TV at least. How was it?
Good.
It was good for you? What was your favorite part?
I think it was probably Christmas Poo.
Christmas Poo. You hear that, everybody? All those great shows, and you chose South Park. All right. You still don't know what rabbit ears are? I'll explain it to you when you're younger.
Look, I think these suck.
Yeah, they're not that great. Tell you what, go throw them away for me, all right? Okay. All right, well, everybody, we are glad to be out of these TVs, and we are so happy to be on your screens and ready for our next comic. Everybody, please give it up.
for Mr. Matt White.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Good. Good to hear. I'm doing okay. For everyone that has asked, and for the people who haven't asked, it's been a lot who haven't. But I thought Black Lives Matter. Anyway, I've been having a tough time sleeping. I have a lot of trouble sleeping lately. I keep having this reoccurring dream about the cops. Okay, this involves me and the cops, and I am chasing the cops. It's like a Grand Theft Auto type video game. I am chasing the cops, and the only movement I have is a knee. And I'm just putting my knee to their backs and killing them over and over again. I call this game Knee to Rights. All right. Okay. Starting off with a bang. All right. Just wrote that down. Shout out to Jeremy, for real, for he was letting everybody know that Black Lives Matter before the incident. Just gonna put that out there. He was helping everybody. So if you didn't know, now you know. I've been lost in my thoughts lately about white people. This ain't rape, but I was just lost in my thoughts lately about white people. And I just wanna take this time to confirm my blackness, okay? I'm black. Here we go. All right. There's more, but I just thought one would do. I thought one would be enough. Honorable mention was grape drink, okay? I love it, and I think it should be an alcoholic beverage. That's just my two cents. All right, here we go. Second honorable mention, just because I said grape drink, I put way too much sugar in my Kool-Aid.
Okay.
Check. All right. And my third honorable mention, because I had three. I couldn't decide. The third one is I didn't swim until college. Just want to put that out there. All right. I know how to swim. Quote the white lady at the end of class, "You know how to swim. You've been faking it the whole time." I was terrified. All right. Keep it moving, trying to keep it light. I love chicken, no, I'm kidding.
and watermelon.
I love chicken, I'm an ass man, oh my God, soul food. If you ever invite me to a cookout, I'm bringing potato salad. Actually, it's just gonna be a regular salad with potatoes in it. you had to make that shit yourself because I don't know how y'all like it. All right, keeping it moving. just killing a little time. What else? I for real though. Shout out to everybody that's protesting everything, putting this out there to the world. This is a very serious thing. And I'm glad that finally people are finally paying attention to it, or at least taking the time to listen to it. So I will put that out there. Let me see. I've been working a lot, so I ain't really had a chance to do too much. But what I have been working on is the part of the show that I like the most. And I think it's about that time that we get into that. So everybody, I hope you're ready for the Matt Watch. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Matt White, and this is
Matt Ford.
And this is the Matt Watch. All right. First of all, Matt Watch, huge fan of Lego, and Lego just announced it's retiring its Lego Creator Expert theme, which is for adults. However, don't be sad. There are more adult Lego sets on the rise, and I have my own personal favorites that I would like to see made. My first is a crack house. A lot of old Lego crackhead minifigures walking around. I think that'll be a lot of fun. I also want to see Walter White's meth mobile lab from Breaking Bad. I think that'll be pretty dope and nostalgic. And I want to see, this is a throwback, but I want to see the set from the show American Gladiators. Dreams do come true.
Yeah, like remember Laser and Blazer?
That's what I'm talking about, man.
Yeah, that's great. All right, well, so San Francisco's Golden Gate Bridge now makes creepy music. Apparently, newly installed railings along the bike path are making this low humming tones that when the wind blows through them, that, you know, it sounds like music. Far out, man. Does it play Stairway? Yelled this high gust.
In my mind, I just want to say, Black Lives Matter.
Yeah.
I just figured that's something they'd do. All right, moving on.
They don't have the
other day, I saw something in the news that made me say, whose Dems is this? Okay. The Democrats were kneeling in a moment of silence for George Floyd. I thought it was a great moment, personally, but they were wearing kente cloth. Whose Dems is this? Like, who thought this was a good idea? Okay. I get it. I understand it. It looks very fashionable. But whose idea was this? I have some ideas as well. I mean, next time you kneel, can we dress them up as slaves from the movie Roots? That might be fun.
Oh, dear.
Or can you put them in orange jumpsuits, like from The Orange is the New Black? I heard that was a thing.
Yeah, even Oh Brother, Where Art Thou would be.
That's what I'm saying. Constant sorrow.
All right. So on Monday, a pilot actually drew out a tribute to the late George Floyd using only his airplane following a flight path in the shape of a raised fist. Very, very cool, right? This was actually a much simpler and subtle message of peace than his first attempt.
All right, we're going to keep this thing on moving. In the news, Karens just can't sit their asses down. In Phoenix the other day, a Karen that was dressed like the Hamburglar was slapped for calling a Hispanic woman not American and telling her to go back to her country, which she was actually raised here. This was hilarious to me because I love the look on Karen's faces. And they like, oh, I didn't expect this to escalate. Oh, I enjoy that look. Can we keep getting that look out of them?
That's actually, yes, we can. And that's actually the newest top-rated show on Netflix is the Karen Reacts. No, but seriously, Netflix did release its list of top-rated originals this week. Topping the list is BoJack Horseman, Stranger Things, Orange is the New Black, and Russian Doll. And no surprise here, at the bottom of the list is Who Wants to Date Carol Baskin? I would actually watch every second of that show, wouldn't you?
Hey, man, hey, sign me up. I don't want to date her. I just want to be in her presence. Just
right? Once. I heard guys are dying to be on that show. Anyway. Oh.
All right. At this time, at this moment, I want to bring in our very special guest. We have a very special guest tonight. This is our Karen watcher on our Matt Watch show. So we'll give it up for our Karen. How's it going, Karen?
Hi, Karen Gillespie here. Just taking a break from a little yoga. So the Matts have asked me to talk to you people about ways of Karen. So one of the things that I've decided to employ is letting everybody know that all Karens aren't bad. Some of us are good. Some of us are really good. And what I want to do is encourage the other Karens of the world to use their Karen-ness for good. For instance, Karen, if you would, instead of calling the manager for a problem, call the manager to report when an employee is doing a great job. Mm. Luis brought me the most beautiful melon. Great job, Luis. Mm. We could call the manager and ask why there are no people of color working here. Mm. We need diversity, Charles. We need diversity. And my favorite, who do we talk to about why I can't lose any of this weight? Karen, I need you on my side. Mm. Going forward, instead of being Karen's who tell on the manager because they're making them wear a mask or stab people and call the police when they knock you out of your electric chair, Karen, use your Karen-ness for good.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
I'm Karen Gillespie. Have a good night.
Wise words. Wise words by Karen Gillespie. Okay.
Awesome. Wait, hold on. Matt, do you hear that?
I do hear. Oh my God. That's the ice cream truck.
That is the ice cream truck.
It's about that time.
That's right. That can only mean one thing. It is time for our new segment called Matt Watches Top 10.
Yeah.
That
all right.
That intro took the entire budget of the show. The entire budget.
Hey, we got to do what we got to do. Takes money to make money. All right. This week, top 10 reasons you need new friends. All right.
That's right.
Take it away.
Starting with number 10, that's Ashley Preston. Starting with number 10, top 10 signs you need new friends. Every one of their videos is in portrait mode. If you don't know what portrait mode is, you're not my friend. Turn your phones this way, please. That's all I got to say.
Number 9, if they invite you to a barn party and tell you it's to die for, time for some new friends.
Top 10 signs you need new friends. Number 8, every day your child starts to look more and more like your buddy Dan.
I can't stand Dan, but they're all around me. All right.
Dan is the new Karen.
This the male Karen. All right. Number 7, top 10 reasons you need new friends. Whenever you're having a conversation and they quote Ben Carson, probably time to get some new friends.
My favorite Ben Carson quote is actually just.
I'm listening.
Number 6, they write happy belated birthday on your Facebook wall. Mm. You're late even on Facebook?
Oh, I'm in this category, so I'm my bad. I'm gonna defriend you after this. Number 5 on 10 reasons you need new friends. If their idea of a good time is shooting guns and learning how to tie rope.
Oh, yeah. That might. You were actually friends with those people? That's, I don't know, that's very.
Yeah, I'm from the South, man.
Number 4. When going to the protest, they always ask, mind if we take your car?
See what I did there?
That's some Karen logic right there.
Karen.
Number 3, if they say they listen to rap music and every song by Jay-Z, they refer to it as the Jay-Z song.
But he does have that one that's really good. All right. Top 10 signs you need new friends. Number 2, they constantly use the phrase, a few bad apples.
And it's gonna number one, okay, or the top 10 reasons you need new friends. When asked, do you play spades? And they respond, what spades?
Oh, and gotta go. Yeah, that is nobody's friend right there.
No.
Well, I think that does it for this week's Matt Watch, right?
Yes, that does it for this week's Matt Watch. To give it up for Matthew Ford and myself.
Our lovely correspondent, pass it back
to Matthew Ford so he can wrap up the show.
And Aaron, our lovely correspondent, and Will for coming to us live from his escape room. And the Mike Tyson Comedy Gang for having the most relaxing set I've ever watched. Bobo for being... No, just Bobo. We love her. And Lucy, thanks so much for kicking us off strong. Jeremy, he left about 30 minutes ago. So
he had to go back in the woods.
That's right. He's deep in the heart of deliverance right now. So, all right. Well, hey, thanks again for everybody. We went 10 minutes over our time, but that's fine. Please, let's all do this again. Tomorrow, or the next day after that, or next week, if you don't mind. I had a blast. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, all the comics. Thank you. Good night, everybody. Bye.